Hello, Lolas. Welcome back to my channel, guys. As I'm here with baby Londyn, and Londyn is the prototype Aspen, sculpted by Claire Teller and painted and rooted by Sylvia Esquire, Sylvia's creation. And so I am going to put her in something uncomfortable. I don't really change her clothes that often, because I don't know, she's more just like, I just love looking at her. I really don't particularly like to see her with a lot of clothes on. So she doesn't, I prefer her to have on stuff that, you know, have her little legs out and stuff like that. She was painted to be a biracial skin tone. And in person, you can see more of her coloring and can tell that she would definitely qualify as a somewhat of a biracial baby, because of black babies are born. They are very light most of the time when they're born, first born, which so if they are mixed with anything other than black, in most cases, they tend to be very, very close to Caucasian babies when they're born. So her being really light does not change the fact of what Sylvia's intentions were with her. And I told Sylvia and I will tell you guys that all the time, she did an amazing job with her skin tone. I really, really love her skin tone. Like I said, she's just one of those babies that I just kind of keep to myself. But yeah, some of my babies, that's just like with Joey. I know I'm going to do a video with him, but my toddlers are just not babies for changing and stuff like that. So I have to be really, really, you know, in a place where I have the time to really do the role play videos with them, because I mean, changing them is not fun on camera. Not for me, and I'm not gonna do it just for you. I know that sounds selfish, but I'm not gonna do it just for you guys. Not only that, you know, these are like part of my collection and they are very valuable to me. So even though people want to see all his little outfit changes or all her outfit changes and stuff like that, I have to do what's good for my collection. And I don't want to put a lot of wear and tear on some of my most expensive prized possessions. And so therefore they don't get changed as often. But, you know, I can always still show them and doing different things. They might just be wearing the same thing. My daughter had a fit about Joey wearing the same thing for days in a row. But I really liked him and I thought he was cute and I just didn't want to change him. But anyway, this was a little romper I had bought for winter, actually. And because winter hadn't got her hair and stuff, she wore it, you know, off camera, I think. But I don't know, I just thought Londyn would be cuter with it because she has hair and I don't have to worry about trying to find a headband or a hat to match. So that's that. Oh my gosh. So yeah, so she is so adorable. I am so excited about the Aspens. Oh my goodness. It's going to be so many cute little Aspens out. I'm going to change her diaper. And I know this diaper might be a little big, actually. I didn't realize it was this big. But sometimes when they have a tummy plate, it's kind of nice when you put on a bigger diaper because it actually, you know, cover up their tummy plate. But the Aspens does come with the half tummy plate, which is nice. And of course the little prototype babies have their little stitching in it that has a Claire Teller doll Aspen prototype, and then it has by Sylvia Creations, and then my Aspen has same thing, but then it says by MsSerenity Smith. So really, really, really nice that Claire does all these special touches with her prototypes and the babies. So, But yeah, it's so tricky with these skin tones and then the community. You know we've talked so much now lately. I think it's because of the climate, the political climate that we wish would not come into, not just political climate, but just the world issues would not come into the doll world. But they have seemed to found their way into our doll world. They've probably already been here, but not as boldly as they are now. And so it's like we are talking about things that probably we shouldn't really care about. So I always feel compelled to really like defend that she is biracial, or you know, it's, you know, all these, you know, different topics, you know, that usually we never even talked about. When, if you look at like the old videos, I mean, I'm gonna go back and look at my videos just to see, did I used to be like, oh, this is, you know, Paris Mia Moore, she was done by so and so and blah 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 blah. I don't think we spent that much time describing were they black, white, Chinese, or otherwise. But now I feel like we, well, maybe not all of us, but some of us, like we do now. And maybe I do it a little bit more because it was a big deal about, you know, artists not painting or having darker skin tone babies, or painting darker skin tone babies as much. And you know, and then there was this big thing that biracial babies basically don't count in the AA community. They have their own section or whatever. But so I was just like, it's crazy. I thought they belong in both communities because they're a mixture of the two, which is why I love biracial babies, because I feel like it's the best of both worlds and it's like a blend. And I thought that you don't have to pick a side then, but I guess some people see it differently, but that's them. Yeah, this shirt is kind of big. Oh, it's almost a little dress for you, girl. But I just wanted to see her in just a little shirt and whatever. I'll probably end up changing her later. I just made her look like she don't come from no type of money. Poor baby. But her looks so cute. And see, that's the thing. And look at her. Did I put her thumb in her mouth? I don't think I did. And you see how it just went in? Like, I love this sculpt. She is just, look at this baby. Oh my gosh, y'all. I love her. So, yep, so this is Londyn. And for those that may have not seen already, Mimi has found her new home, which was my toddler. She is now Cassidy, and she's on Sun Sam Baby's channel, my sissy. So, I don't know if y'all noticed this pattern here lately, but all the babies that have like a special something connect to me, my sissy always end up with them. She got my Noah, she has Puck, and now she has Mimi. And yeah, it's just, you know, she does have the one Asian baby that I ever had, and then she got a whole bunch of other great babies from, you know, her own personal collecting. She has a baby that's similar to Lizzie, but it's not Lizzie. But she is so gorgeous. What is her name? Oh my God, I can't believe I forgot her name. I normally always remember her name. It's because I'm trying to think of it. But yeah, and everybody knows Iris. And she has Major and... No, Mason. Yeah, Major and Mason. Mason, I painted like when I first started when painting. I had just kind of still was new, and that was the first Dwayne asleep that I painted when the kids first came out, and I had forgot about that. And she has him, and that's actually one of her favorite babies. You know, I was done with that thing. It's like you might have other babies that might be more amazing, because in my opinion, she has other babies now that's way more amazing than the Mason that I painted for her. But to her, Yeah, she's, you know, she's bonded to him. So that's pretty cool. But anyway, I'm not going to spend my whole video talking about my sissy, but y'all can definitely check out her channel. I shared the video on my community tab for you guys to check it out. Like I do that sometime. I don't, you know, people be like, oh, can you shout me out? Da 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 da. I don't really do that. If I feel like I want to share a video with the community, I try to share it on the community tab. So guys, if you're not, you haven't clicked the bell to be a part of all my notifications, make sure you do that, because sometimes I share other people's channels there. And just FYI, for some reason, I think you have to have so many subscribers or something, either subscribers or views or something, to where I can actually tag you in that post, because I noticed I can tag certain channels in the post on the community tab, but I can't tag other people. So I don't know how that works. So I mean, it doesn't really matter, a big deal, but it does, it helps let them know that they've been tagged or their video have been shared. But people can still just click on the link and go to the channel. So it's not that big of a deal as far as, you know, sharing their videos. But anyway, I just try to share love because I feel like this community, I have a lot of people that have really, really shown me a lot of love over the years. And, you know, I am just grateful for, you know, everybody that do genuinely like me, support my channel, or, you know, love what I do here on YouTube, social media. I know I don't do as much as I used to, but, you know, times change and things get busy. But anyway, thanks guys again for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed Londyn. I am off to back to rooting. I'm getting very, very close, guys. And then soon I'll be able to share Luca with you guys, fully rooted and ready to go. So, yeah, I'm even skipping a important event today just so I can stay home and root. So I think my guy is outside. Let me see. Oh, wait, I'll cut the video off. Because I hear the lawnmower. I know that's probably him. He just kicks here so early in the morning. He's creepy. I think he's Joe. He's Joe, guys. Oh, my gosh. Okay, let me go. Bye.